Mason Barto's dad recorded this video the morning his wife told their son, a San Diego researcher, found the cause of his rare and life-threatening genetic disorder.
There's all these genes, and they knew that there was one in your body that was causing all these problems, but they couldn't find it. They found it.
You can see when 10-year-old Mason realizes the implications for him and others who have congenital disorders of glycosylation, or CDG.
So does it mean there's going to be a fix? It means probably that there's going to be days that you might not have to have your tube hooked the other time. And it means that when other kids get sick like this, they won't have to look so much. They'll know right where to go.
A few months later, Mason and his family traveled from their home in Pennsylvania to the Sanford-Burnham Medical Research Institute in La Jolla to meet the doctor who discovered the gene responsible for his severe medical problems.
And we have a picture of the whole lab wearing our Mason's Hope t-shirts.
He said he'd want to come and meet Dr. Freeze and shake his hand. And so that's why we're here.
So discovering Mason's gene sets you up to then go back to the basic science and say, here's something we never even thought about before. We have no idea how this works.
Freeze hopes the gene discovery will lead to new treatments. In the meantime, Mason and his family joined others for a tour of the lab and a chance to talk directly with researchers from around the country.
Rare diseases really provides Rosetta Stones for understanding much more about physiology, much more about common disorders.
CDG is far from common. Mason was 2 years old when he was finally diagnosed, even though he nearly died the night he was born.
He was born with a cleft palate and a small jaw. And we actually didn't know that he had as many severe problems as he had until the first night of his birth, when he quit breathing.
This helped me breathe.
And CDG makes it impossible for Mason to maintain life-sustaining blood sugar levels. So 5 times a day, he ingests a special sugar cocktail through a tube in his stomach to keep his blood sugars high enough to sustain organ function.
I eat no blood sugar, and I can't do a lot. Like, I can't run for a long time like other people.
Still, he's able to play ball with his 14-year-old brother. He attends school daily and gets good grades.
He's proved from day one that he's going to beat this, so he makes it very easy to go on.
Eric Green, director of the National Human Genome Research Institute, says Mason's new genetically based treatment and response will become part of a genetic database for the National Institutes of Health.
We have now set up in the past just couple of months several specialized centers who will take in samples from really around the world of individuals with very rare genetic diseases and use state-of-the-art genome sequencing technologies and analysis methods. We believe we can industrialize the elucidation of the genetic cause of these rare disorders.
Meanwhile, Mason is soaking up all that Southern California has to offer.
We went to Legoland, Disneyland, the zoo, and SeaWorld.
All the while, living by his best friend's motto, take a chance.
I have a dog.
You have a dog? What's your dog's name?
Chance. He's my best friend.